Lord, we have prayed. We give you glory now as we worship you. Settled in the mighty name of Jesus. As we all know, this is our month of settlement. Whether the devil likes it or yes, the only person that can stop you from being settled is just you. But God will help us that we will not in any way shortchange ourselves from the glorious destiny that God has for us this month in the name of Jesus. And I've captured this, my brief exhortation, just to charge us up. Return and be settled. Praise the Lord. Let's return back to the ancient landmark and be settled. Praise the Lord. Romans 6:1 says that should we continue in sin and expect the grace of God to abound? We cannot continue to be doing the same things that we have been doing years back and expect the grace of God. And God has said that we will be settled. It is a month of settlement. Oh yes, that's what He has desired of us this month. But should we continue to do the same old things that we have been doing that has been causing us not to be settled in different areas of our lives? I don't think that's what the Word of God encourages us to do. So today, it's something that is just what will spur us up to put us in check also. So that by the end of this month, when we begin to take stocks, we would have said, indeed, Lord, you said you will settle me, and indeed you settled me. Praise the Lord. And our text will be taken from Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 8 to 10. Deuteronomy 30, 8 to 10. I'll read from here. And thou shalt return and obey the voice of the Lord, and do all his commandments, which I command thee this day. Verse 9. And the Lord thy God will make thee plenteous in every work of thy hand, in the fruit of thy body, and in the fruit of thy cattle, and in the fruit of thy land, for good. For the Lord will again rejoice over thee for good, as he rejoiced over thy fathers, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God to keep his commandments, his statutes, which are written in this book of the law. And if thou turn unto the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy might. It's very simple. It's more simpler than what it is. You say it's simple too. Obedience is just what God needs from us. so many things that we think that we have not gotten. It's just simple obedience. Just very simple obedience. You said this, oh yes, Lord. Well, I'm praying that God, it sounds very simple. I don't know why we find ourselves wanting in this place of obedience. That's a place we have to pray very early on time. As this month is just started, that Father, you pray that because it's faith cleaning, so that your faith is charged up today, so that by the time Papa will be coming up to round up, we will go home with bountiful blessing. You will say, Father, please, the grace to be obedient to your word. The grace to be obedient, please release upon me today. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I ask that in your mercy, it is obedience you seek. You say you do not seek for sacrifice. It's only obedience that you ask for. Oh Lord, your word that we'll be hearing today, your word will continue to search even when we live here. You will help us to obey your statutes. And Lord, because you are not a man that you will lie, you will keep your own end of the bargain. You will settle us indeed in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father, because we know because we have asked. You said we should ask and it shall be granted unto us. It shall be granted unto us in the name of Jesus. What the pastor say on Sunday when the word comes, we should what? We should take the word and run with it. It's not just for you to hear the word. What does it mean to run? It's to obey. It's simple. Pastor didn't mean that when you hear the word, carry it and begin to run. Run to obey. It's for you to stay in the place of obedience. If you obey it, hook, line, and sinker. Lord, I know you know the thing. You know everything. You know. He knows. He still says obey. You know it's not. He knows that thing you are saying. You know. He knows. Truly, he knows. He knows, but he still expects us to obey to the latter. Your obedience that is partial is disobedience. Your obedience that is late is disobedience. God says do this. You will not say, wait. When the thing is now to your truth, you will not say, okay, finally. It's disobedience. Those are the things that have been shortchanging us from the blessings that God has from us. But we trust God that as we begin to align ourselves in the place of obedience, our testimonies will be sure in the name of Jesus. Let's see what James chapter 1, verse 22 and verse 25 says to us. He said, but ye, be ye doers of the word that you hear. That's what pastor means by running. Take the word, believe it, and run with it. Bible is saying, James 1, is saying that we should what? Not just be hearers of this word. It's very good. We come to church every now and then. We hear it. But what do we do with this word? What do we do with it? Do we practicalize it? It should be what it is. It comes out from inside of us because we love God and he says, obey my commandments. That's what a duty for man. Praise the Lord. Verse 20, he said, but ye be ye the doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. When we don't get settled, we are deceiving ourselves. It's not God we are deceiving. Any of us that is not settled, I'm standing and I'm praying that God, in your mercy, you will settle every one of us individually. But anyone that is not settled, it is not the fault of God. It's when we don't obey to the latter, that's when we become shortchanged. But the mercy of God will speak for you, to speak for me also in the name of Jesus. Verse 25 says, but whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he be not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deeds. It's very, I don't know, things of God, I don't know if it's us that will make it so difficult. They are very, very, I don't know, devil is one thing, so I don't understand. He makes things look as if it's so difficult, but the words of God are just so plain. All the people that say rema, rema, the word of God is plain. It's so very, very plain. God will help us to align ourselves with the word of God, and our testimonies will begin to hear resounding testimonies. Pastor will hear testimonies and he will not be tired because we are plenty in this house in the name of Jesus. And I have an encouragement for somebody that has been saying, I've returned to God all this while. I've been doing his will. I am standing here to say, there is no problem. Shebi, you have been doing it. Between God and man, you have been standing in the place of obedience. Let's see what 1 Peter 5 verse 10 says to you. And I think that's our text for this month. 1 Peter 5 verse 10. And that's my last word. Because I say I've come to just charge us to encourage us, to admonish us, as the case will be, so that when we are moving every day, let it be something that is resonating inside of us every day. As you wake up, Lord, what is the word for today? The grace to obey this word that will grant me settlement in every area of my life. First Peter is saying to just one person, that person that has been saying, God, but you know me, you search the heart. You know I've been standing in a place of obedience. He says, but the God of all grace, who have called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that you have suffered a while, make you perfect. He will establish you. He will strengthen you. And he will settle you. He will settle you. He will settle me in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's bow down our head and appreciate the Most High God that has brought this word to us this evening. My time is almost up. Thank God. Let's appreciate God that God, you have been deep. You have proposed it. You do not just call us and just tell us words like that. We believe and we know it within us that your word you don't speak in vain. But Lord, the grace for us to receive all that you have desired for us in this world. Let us not, Lord, hinder your move in our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. Blessed be your holy name. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. In Jesus' mighty name.